أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سورة المزمل. In the name of Allah, the most affectionate, the merciful. Section 1, Ayat number 5.
إِنَّا سَنُلْقِي عَلَيْكَ قَوْلًا ثَقِيلًا.
Certainly we are charging you with a heavy word. In the commentary it is mentioned, this means very soon we will reveal verses of reinforcing audiences, which will prove heavy for the people. Therefore you should make them accustomed to heavy and difficult audiences. Ayat number 6.
Inna nashi'ata al-layli hiya ashaddu wat'an wa aqwa muqilan.
Indeed, the rising up by the night is the firmest way to subdue the soul and the best corrective measure for the words of prayer. In the commentary it is mentioned, this means waking up at night from sleep for performing salah is more unbearable than other salahs. This tells us that salatul tahajjud should be performed after waking up from sleep. The tahajjud salah is very important and beneficial. The fear of Allah Almighty and the humility that one obtains in this salah is not achieved in other salahs. Ayat number 7.
Inna laka fin nahari sabhan tawilan.
Verily, you have in the daytime a long schedule of engagements. In the commentary it is mentioned, this means during the day there are many propagation activities for you. Therefore night is the best time to communicate with us. Ayat number 8.
وَذْكُرْ إِسْمَ رَبِّكَ وَتَبَتَّلْ إِلَيْهِ تَبْتِيلًا.
And remember the name of your Lord and devout yourself to Him with exclusive devotion. In the commentary it is mentioned, before commencing the recitation of the Holy Quran, always read Bismillah, or besides Salah, recite the names of Allah Almighty at different times by reading glorification and declaration of the unity of Allah Almighty, Tasbih and Tahleel. This means that besides the salah, your blessed life should be such that even if you are physically involved in any activities, your heart should reflect nothing besides Allah Almighty. However, this verse does serve as proof to cut oneself from the world, which Islam forbids. Sallu alal Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا حبيب الله الصلاة والسلام عليك يا نبي الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا نور الله. Excellence of reciting through the Pak, the Prophet of mankind, the peace of our hearts and mind, the most generous and kind, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallam has stated, whoever recites Salat upon me 100 times, Allah Azza wa Jal inscribes between his two eyes that he is freed from hypocrisy and the fire of hell and on the day of judgment. And He Azza wa Jal will be kept. He Azza wa Jal will keep him with the martyrs. Sallu alal Habib sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Excellence of reciting Surah Mulk Sharif. I'm just going to mention some of the hadith regarding it, inshallah. The Holy Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has stated, "It is my wish that Tabarak alladhi bi yadihi al-mulk," i.e. Surah Mulk, "be in the hearts of every believer." So my dear Islam brothers, try to make an intention of reciting Surah Mulk Sharif every night before going to sleep. As you know, alhamdulillah, when you come to the mahal of Dawood-e-Islami, when you connect yourself towards the masjid, alhamdulillah, after Salat al-Maghrib every day, Surah Mulk Sharif is recited. And obviously, in the ijtimas of Dawood-e-Islami, Surah Mulk Sharif is obviously recited there as well. And this way, you can receive the barakah. If you cannot recite Surah Mulk Sharif, at least by listening to it, you're attaining the reward as well, inshaAllah. Sallu alal Habib, sallallahu ta'ala ala Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.